So, let's talk a bit about artillery weapon systems in Arma 2 with the ACE mod installed, or rather Operation Arrowhead. What we have or had earlier was artillery guns in the game, and it had an artillery computer along with it. So you would just get in the gun, click or open the artillery computer, click on the map, maybe set a range, close, medium and far, and then hit fire. And what would happen is you'd fire around and you would probably be guaranteed to hit the target you desired. Which of course is quite unbalanced. You wouldn't want to have artillery guns in your mission because everybody could just spam target areas fairly quickly and it wouldn't be realistic at all. So what the ACE developers did actually, they implemented artillery guns that are quite realistic in the procedures you need to do in order to be able to fire them. And in this tutorial, or part one of it, I'm going to show you how to use the artillery computer to actually calculate firing solutions. And what I have is a gun that is set up on the airfield in the north of Pakistan, and there is this special Humvee. And inside of this Humvee, you're gonna have to place it through the editor or when you create the mission, there is a artillery computer. So let me get in here real quick. As a driver or code driver, doesn't really matter. You got this action menu entry, use AN slash GYK 37BCS, which is basically the artillery battery computer. And it looks sort of like this. Right now it's a little bit misaligned because it's still in development, but it's gonna be sorted out in the near future, so it's gonna look a little bit prettier. So what we're gonna do is actually put in a battery name, and what you put in this side, you actually don't really need to make up something fancy. Nobody else will be able to see this. It's basically just for your own information, and of course to target your firing and calculate your firing solution. So I'm gonna put in a battery name. I'm just gonna name this Howitzer because I don't have any fantasy. Then the FTC call sign is our own call sign. So I'm gonna put in Steel Rain, quite a common artillery name. And then there's the battery type, which is the Howitzer. You can't really put in anything else right now. It just supports the M119er. So there's the grid. So I need to find out the grid of the gun. How do we do that? Well, either have somebody tell me this, or I get out of the gun, walk up, out of the Humvee, walk up to the gun, and then open my map. And because I have a GPS device, on the bottom it tells me the grid I'm in. It's an 8-figure grid. So the first four digits are the horizontal axis, and the second four digits are the vertical axis. And you notice the map only has three digits per axis. This one has four, so it's a little bit more accurate. And you're gonna want to use an 8-figure grid compared to a 6-figure grid because accuracy is times 10 greater. And because I'm standing next to the gun, it tells me my current grid is 0589 1160. So I'm gonna want to write that down either on a note of paper, sheet of paper, or you're just gonna remember this, depending on well, actually how good you are on that stuff. I wrote that down because I can't remember anything for the life of me. And it also tells you the height. This is 2082 meters, and you're gonna want to write that down too because this is important. You're gonna have to adjust for height of your gun position and target position. So I have these two pieces of information, 2082 and 0589 1160 as a grid, and what I also need to know is the alignment of the gun. So either you get behind the gun, you open your compass, and you see it's 40 degrees. And actually what you want to have to write down is not degrees, but mils. So one circle has 360 degrees or 6,400 mils. And if you look at the compass, actually you can see I'm pointing at 40 mils, and behind that there's a smaller outer circle which has different numbers. So this would be 6, which actually stands for 600 mils, so it's times 100. And at 40, it's roughly 700 mils, or if you want to calculate that to be more precise, it's 711 mils, and you want to be that precise because this is going to matter depending on how far your target is away. We need that extra precision, and best way to do this is to actually know as a mission maker how you set up the gun, and then just give that to the artillery operator. Or you can measure that with the Vector Knight device, actually. If I pull that out, look through this, and try to adjust myself so that I'm actually directly in the center of the gun, and load the battery, Notice it has 39 degrees now, and because I know this, I'm just going to point this at 40 degrees. And if I press the Alt key and R for Romeo, it switches to mils, and it says 717 mils. This isn't that accurate. What I can do is walk out a little bit further and then align myself again with the gun, and I'm now at 710 mils, which actually well, quite okay for accuracy. The actual setting is 711 mils, but 710 would do fine too. So you could find out the direction of the barrel like this. So I'm just gonna hide this again, get back into the Humvee with the artillery computer, and open it. And you can see it actually remembered what I put down earlier, so I don't have to retype this every time I get into the computer. So like before, the grid of our gun is 0589. You remember we measured that from the GPS device, and vertical axis 1160, so 8-figure grid. The altitude was 2082, and the direction of fire was 711 mils. And I want to put in a target prefix, which is target number 1, target number start 1, because it's the first target. You can put in arbitrary numbers, it's just for your own, well, so that you can remember and reference fire missions. And for ease of use, I'm going to put in a known point, a new known point, and I'm going to put in the target. So I'm just going to put in a gas station. I didn't show you this yet, but on the map, I actually had a target in mind. What I'm going to target is in Garmazar, back here, there's this neat little gas station. So I'm just going to put in a marker on there, says target. And what I need to know, of course, is the grid again. And I can do this the same, but without the GPS device, because I'm actually not on that location. But I can see at the bottom 104, and like I said, it's divided in 10 more grids, subgrids, to be more precise. And I'm going to estimate this is 104, maybe 2, or maybe even 3. I'm just going to go ahead and say 1042. This starts at 0 and goes to 10. And for the vertical axis, it's 063, and it's, well, probably 063 and 3. So it starts on the bottom, goes up to 10, because you can see the number goes higher from south to north. Depending on the map, that might be different for your mission. So we're going to have for target coordinates 1042, 0633, and the elevation, the map also shows me this, is 2258 meters. And this is all I'm going to have to know about the target. So I'm going to close the map. You can see, you can open the map and close it with this button here. And gas station. So grid 1042 and 0633. Altitude 2258 meters. I'm going to click on add or update. And you can see it now has gas station in my known points. And so I'm going to want to compute the target or firing solution. I'm going to click on grid. And right here I'm going to have to retype the information I just typed in. So 1042 0633, altitude 2258, target description, gas station. You're going to want to write something down here, it's not really necessary, but it's just for your own reference. So radius 50 meters, length 50 meters, and attitude, which is basically the alignment of the target from east, west, north, south. I'm just going to put in an alignment directly east to west. In mils would be 1600. Remember, 6400 is a whole circle, divide that by 4, and you have 1600 or 4 mils or 90 degrees directly east. Method of engagement. Danger close? Yes or no? I'm gonna leave this at no, because I don't have any friendly units in the area. Were there any friendly units and they are closer than 600 meters, probably gonna want to put a yes here to let them know, or for my information, that there is friendly units in the area which are quite close, and I might hit them by accident if I don't have the fire mission set up correctly. Notes. I'm gonna not put something down there. Don't really need to. It's not necessary. Ammunition type. You got HE, DPICM, smoke, or elimination. And DPICM, well, HE is the standard HE round, you know, from most of the movies, I guess. It explodes on the target and then does a heck of a lot of damage. DPICM is sort of like a cluster bomb in artillery form. So this explodes in mid-air if you set it up correctly, and then it's gonna spread some smaller explosions all over the area below where the shell exploded. There's smoke, pretty well self-explanatory. Illumination, which well illuminates the target area. I'm just gonna leave this at HE. And then there's fuse type. You have four options. Point detonate does exactly what it sounds like. It detonates once the round hits the ground. There's proximity, which lets the round detonate 10 meters above the ground. Time and delay. So if you set a time, a diffuse time, the round is going to explode after the amount of seconds you set in here. For example, if the round takes 62 seconds to reach the target, you put in 60 seconds here, and it will explode 2 seconds before impact. That might be interesting for smoke grenades and DPICM grenades, or elimination, of course, so that you have it explode in mid-air, not directly on the ground, because that, of course, wouldn't make any sense for elimination grenades. Just have them illuminate directly on the ground would be kind of stupid. But for HE, we're gonna just leave this at point detonate, so I don't have to put in anything at fuse time. But round count, I'm gonna set to 1, because I wanna fire exactly 1 round. Adjustment round count, I'm gonna leave at 1, like adjust piece, also 1. Sheaf, parallel, you don't have any options, just leave that there. And method of control, basically how you interact with your gunner on the gun, because you're not gonna do this on your own, like I do in this tutorial. It's kind of stupid, because it takes forever. And in real missions, you wouldn't set up the gun manually on your own. And you're gonna see that later, it's quite impractical to do this on yourself. So, fire when ready, fire at my command, or time from now, or time from clock. I'm just gonna leave this at fire when ready, so I'm gonna leave that blank, not need that. And then I'm gonna hit fire for effect, or adjust fire. And you're gonna see in the bottom, it's gonna calculate all the different solutions for me. And it's gonna come up with two different ones. There's a low solution for the most direct arc of fire, and there's a high solution, which shoots the round high up in the air and then comes down at a very steep angle. And for most missions, I'm gonna use the high solution because, for example, there might be mountains in the way. And if I used the low solution, and this is gonna be the most direct way for the round to go, it's probably gonna impact on that mountain which is in the way. And the high solution, of course, very steep, comes in at a high angle, wouldn't hit the mountain if any mountain would be in the way. And on Tagestan, there's a lot of mountains, so you're probably never going to use the low solution. And it actually tells you the time to impact. The low solution would be 15 seconds after you shoot the gun. The high solution, 56.7 seconds. And if I actually click on these two buttons, it's going to start a countdown for me, which tells me after the shot, in how many seconds, if I forget, the round will impact on the ground, to relay maybe the splash message to the forward observer, so he knows when he's gonna have to expect the round to come down. Like I said, there's two solutions, and I'm gonna write down the information for the high solution, because that's what I'm gonna use. And it says fire mission, the shell type, the charge, which is important for the gunner or the ammo man. So charge 6, just write this down, so you know how to prep the arty round. It says the fuse type, fuse quick, so point detonation, deflection for 966 mils. I'm going to talk about this once I get to the second part of the tutorial, and quadrant or elevation. Also in mils, how high you have to aim the gun to be on target with that kind of charge, and the distance or time you put in if you choose another fuse type. So quadrant 1096. And this is what you would relay to your gunner on the gun, or your team on the gun, for them to be able to set the gun in the right direction and then fire upon your command. So we don't need this anymore. I press escape. We have our firing solution. And this is what you're gonna do if you are the commander of the gun, computing firing solutions. In part 2 of the tutorial, I'm going to talk about how to actually set the gun we have here with the fire solution we just calculated. So if you're interested in that, just watch the second part of the tutorial. But thank you for now.